Well, more now on the flood crisis unfolding across Greater Sydney. I want to bring in Hawkesbury Mayor Patrick Connolly in Windsor and Northern Beaches Mayor Michael Regan in Manly. Good morning to you both. Gee, it's been a bloody busy overnight. Patrick, first to you. We've got multiple suburbs in your region overnight forced to evacuate. How many people are we actually talking about here that are displaced?
Look, we're talking about some thousands across the suburbs of McGraths Hill, Windsor, South Windsor, that all got evacuated last night, and many more had been evacuated days earlier. We've had some people out of their houses now for, I think, 5 or 6 days. So, quite a number of people now.
And that's the thing. I mean, we all knew that this was sort of coming, but I guess it's really difficult to prepare for such an event, isn't it? Are you comfortable the area has been well prepared enough for what's expected now today as well, the peak and then obviously recovery?
Yeah, look, this is that situation yesterday where we had to evacuate those suburbs. That's the first time we've had to evacuate mass suburban areas. So that's the sort of the worst case we've been planning for the last few days. Unfortunately, it was required. And the evacuation route down Windsor Road did shut last night, which is why we had to get those people out. So that was a well-run operation. And I think everyone who wanted to leave was able to leave. Just fingers crossed that rain's finished and this is the peak today and that there's no more evacuations needed.
Yeah, absolutely. Michael, I want to bring you in now. Parts of the northern beaches faced serious flash flooding as the Manly Dam spilled over yesterday. I mean, we saw those shots of cars passing by classrooms, you know, entire driveways give way, basically. What are the conditions like there this morning?
This morning, it's still a bit of drizzle around, but we're not near as bad as what's up there at Patrick. A big shout-out to you, mate. Hope we can help and hope everything goes well for you guys. But here in the northern beaches, people are out doing their clean-ups at the moment. There's people down at Manly here doing their exercises. But, look, yesterday was bizarre. It was intense. It was biblical. Roseville Bridge being cut off with something else. And then overnight, we've had probably about 20-odd landslips. So there's a lot of properties that are under a geotech investigation at the moment, which is significant. So they're still not in their homes. Others that have been assessed are in their homes. But there's just a wide variety of damage and debris. And that's our focus today. And hopefully these winds won't be as bad as predicted.
And that's the thing, isn't it? I guess as people are getting about trying to sort of clean up following yesterday's damage, they really should be worried or at least prepared for more to come. You know, you mentioned there the softened terrain around the area. It's pretty dangerous still.
Yeah, very dangerous. I mean, debris in the roads alone is pretty bad. The debris in the parks and all the walking trails, etc., is all very bad. But yeah, the landslips is the significant one, I think, is the one that we're focusing on. And there's just the clean-ups that we'll go through now, and we'll hopefully get some of those roads open that are closed currently. But we need to do some serious assessments, and the crews have been out all night. So thank you to all of them, the emergency services in particular, huge effort.
You're getting the help that you need?
Yeah, we are at the moment. We need to start talking with the state government, with the other councils, I think, and the federal government about how these things are going to be more frequent, more severe, and not one every 10 years, not one every 100 years. We need to start talking about how we manage this better going forward, because not every council is in a position like we are to be able to afford to fix these things up, because they are going to be more frequent.
Yeah, indeed. Very well said. Thank you, Michael and Patrick. Our thoughts are with you and your communities today. Good luck.
I think they've spoken for years about how to mitigate the roads there. Nothing has been done there. Mm. Let's get an update now on where that wild weather system is tracking and how it's affecting residents' power across the state. Big problem, isn't it? Meteorologist Jackson Brown joins us now from BOM and Scott Ryan from Endeavour Energy in Parramatta. Guys, good morning to you. Jackson, to you first of all. I mean, how much rain is predicted to fall in New South Wales today? Can you give us an overview?
Look, it's only nuisance falls, as other people have pointed out, that east coast low has moved offshore. It's replaced by quite a brisk southerly airstream, and that airstream has enabled a lot of that rainfall to be clipped well offshore. So we're only talking nuisance falls with just oncoming onshore showers, rather.
It was bigger than a nuisance yesterday, wasn't it? There were some tremendous falls, the like of which we haven't seen in a long time.
Yeah, and it was pretty much a bullseye on those northern suburbs of Sydney. We did get up to 148 millimetres within the city there, and some of that occurring over quite a short space of time. Thankfully, the falls out towards the Hawkesbury Nepean catchment were on the order of around 25 to 40 millimetres, but it's important to remember that they did suffer heavy falls in the 24 hours previous, and hence why that river system is back in major.
What woke me up last night was not the rain on the tin roof, but the wind. They were extreme.
Yeah, Molyneux Point down at Port Botany got 111 kilometres an hour last night. Kurnell on the beaches there got 100 kilometres an hour last night. We are expecting that damaging wind warning, rather the severe weather warning for damaging winds, to ease as the winds ease out later today.
Yeah, I saw a couple of planes landing yesterday too. That was not pretty if you're in a plane. No, good on you, Jackson. Thank you. It's now bringing Scott Ryan from Endeavour Energy. Scott, thank you for your time again this morning. Just how many homes are right now without power and which areas?
Yeah, thanks, Carl. Last night at around about 11 o'clock, we had 7,000 customers without supply. But as Jackson from the Bureau indicated, we had some other severe storms roll through that evening. So we're now sitting at 9,600 customers without supply, not just in those flood-prone areas, but also across our franchise area to Blue Mountains, Southern Highlands, South Coast.
How long before you expect that power to be fully restored?
For the customers impacted last night outside of the flood zones, I'd expect the majority of those to get their supply back today. The flood zone impacts, as you can see on the screens right now, that's harder because we need to get access, but this isn't our first storm response. It isn't our first flood response. We did this last year. And what our experience tells us is that once we get access, within 2, potentially 3 days, we'll have the majority of those customers back. So we have a flood response plan. It is predicated on the flood levels dropping over the next couple of days, at which point we'll start to see those customers restore to supply.
Imagine that, having a flood response plan. Anyway, good to talk to you. Thank you for your time today. Appreciate it. And good luck getting that power back on for the people out there.
For an update on the crisis impacting New South Wales, I want to bring in Assistant Commissioner Dean Storey from the SES. Dean, hello, and thanks for fitting us into your very busy schedule. Another round of evacuation orders overnight. How many rescues did your team respond to?
Yeah, still a very busy night. Although the rain has eased today, we're still seeing floodwaters very high and rising in some parts of Greater Sydney. So overnight, almost 2,600 requests for assistance were responded to by the SES, and also 91 flood rescues as well. So still a lot of activity out there. A lot of roads and areas are still flooded. And I guess the key message this morning is, as people sort of wake up and leave their homes, is avoid unnecessary travel if you're in those flood-affected areas. If you can stay off the roads, please do so. And never drive through floodwaters. If it's flooded, forget it. Turn around and find another way.
We're just seeing pictures of DY, the Corso and Manly on Sydney's northern beaches. But what suburbs are of your concern and your focus today?
Still huge parts of the state impacted by floodwaters. As it stands this morning, 60 evacuation orders are still in force and 27 evacuation warnings affecting some 60,000 residents. So it's still a very dynamic and volatile situation out there. But key focus areas today include parts of the Hawkesbury River, North Richmond, Wiseman's Ferry, Windsor, and also in the Hunter around Singleton as well. So they're going to be our focus today and for the coming days. Floodwaters are still very high at major flood levels and rising in some areas as well. So really urging the community in those areas in particular to remain vigilant, monitor your local conditions, weather forecasts, and heed those warnings and advice from the SES and local authorities.
All right, good advice. We'll let you get back to it, Dean. Thanks so much.